Our topic is angle of dip. We have seen that to know the total characteristics of the Earth's magnet, we need three information. One is declination, one is angle of dip, and one is strength of horizontal magnetic field. We have done declination and now we are doing angle of dip. What does it mean? We have seen Earth's magnetic field is represented by a magnetic needle, and its direction we can know by it. When we hang, it gives its direction. Okay. Now, our magnetic needle can rotate in horizontal plane because we have given it a pivot like this, and it can rotate, free to rotate. Now suppose I turn it this way. This is now pivot. Now it is free to rotate this way. If I make it like this, then it has a freedom to tell me that whether magnetic field is in this direction or in this direction or in this direction. What does it tell? It has a slight dip on one side towards the Earth's surface. This. At other location I take it, there it stand like this. At other location it stand this way. So what I find that it is always making certain angle with the Earth if I allow to rotate it on this pivot. In which plane? In vertical plane. Again, I take this magnetic needle this way. This is the axis of rotation. Now it is free to rotate in horizontal plane. It rotates and stops in north-south direction. If it stops in north-south direction, I come to know this is north-south direction. I take out my pivot from here and put my pivot here, or I rotate it here itself. Whatever north south in this plane it wanted to rotate, it has rotated. It does not need to rotate. It is not experiencing any torque in this because I have allowed it to make the torque zero and it has come here. Now I allow it to rotate in vertical plane, and further it rotates like this and stops. Now it is in this plane as well as in this plane it has rotated. So what does it represent? It represents the magnetic field of the Earth, intensity of magnetic field of the Earth, which is in north-south plane in this direction. So this is representing intensity of the magnetic field of the Earth, and this always makes certain direction with the surface of the Earth. The angle between the two, magnetic field intensity of the Earth and horizontal plane on the surface of the Earth, this angle is known as angle of dip. So that is its definition. Angle of dip is the angle between, this is angle of dip is angle between intensity of the Earth's magnetic field B and horizon. What is horizon? Surface of the Earth. So at this place, this, I draw this place. I am standing here. Here this is horizon or horizontal direction. Here I find the direction of needle finally, which is allowed to rotate in all the directions. It finally stays in this direction. Then this angle, let's write it delta. This angle is angle of dip. This is magnetic needle and this is horizontal direction H, and this is direction of magnetic field B. This is angle of dip. How this angle of dip is formed? That is the next question. So when I put my magnetic needle here, I find this is the direction. When I put it here, I find this is the direction. So I draw a line here. Here, this is the direction. Here, this is the direction. Here, this is the direction. So if I join all these, I find the magnetic field lines created in the earth. Okay, these two are magnetic north and south. These lines are coming almost from this area and this way. These are approximate magnetic field lines created by Earth's magnet, which has got pole somewhere here inside these two. So this is inside the magnet, this is outside the magnet. So it goes like this. Okay. This is magnetic field pointing here, because this is south, this is north. I put a needle here, needle mark towards north. That is why I put arrow in this direction. Okay, now when I put needle here, it shows needle stays in this direction. And where is horizontal? This is horizontal direction. See, the tangent here is horizontal direction. Needle stay in this direction, and there is a angle between the two. This is angle of dip. Earth's magnetic field intensity B, and this is H. So this is the angle of dip. If I draw it here, this, if I draw it here, then this is direction of intensity, either this way or this way. This is horizontal direction, this is angle of dip, this is B. So this is known as angle of dip. We can find it out with help of an instrument known as Dip's circle. Dip's circle is a device we use in the lab. You can see it there or you can see it on the internet. It is only a device which can rotate. It has a circle frame, and here is a needle. On this, there is a markation of degrees. This is all 360 degrees. We start from here. This is 0 degree. This goes here 90. This goes here 90. Okay. Now, we have a needle here. And this is covered from both the side with glass so that we can see this. This is again fitted on another frame. On the table, we draw a line with help of a needle, and that line is north-south, north-south. On this line, we place this frame. So this becomes north-south. So it need not to rotate this way, it has a freedom. Now we find that this has rotated in a particular direction, this, and this angle, this gives the angle of dip, that's all. Anywhere you place it in north-south meridian, and see, this gives you the reading of dip. So this is dip circle. So this is angle of the dip. And how do we use the angle of dip? If this is intensity, this intensity can be divided or can be resolved in two directions. Which are these two directions? One is the direction of my tabletop. This is horizontal direction. One is vertical direction. I divide it into two. If this is B, I resolve it. This will be what? B cos delta, and this will be B sin delta. This B cos delta is in which direction? In horizontal direction. So I call it horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Okay, and its name is H. What is H? H is horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. This is Earth's magnetic field, but not the full field. It is only component in this, and this is what? B cos delta. So B cos delta is H. In other words, we can write that H is equal to B cos delta. Then vertical direction, we give it a name BV, B vertical. This was what? B horizontal component, B cos delta, and B vertical is equal to B sine delta. So these are the two components of the Earth's magnetic field, one acting in vertical direction and one acting in horizontal direction. How do you place your table in the lab? So answer, we place it in horizontal direction. So if I place my magnet here, it experiences force and turn. Then which component of the Earth's magnetic field is affecting it? Yes, it is horizontal component. That is why horizontal component is more useful for us, because it is spread on the plane of our laboratory. That is why we need this H. Once we know H, we can find out both the things. How? Divide these two. So B, B is cancelled, and what do we get here? B, V upon H is equal to tangent delta, or B, V is equal to H tangent delta. Okay. How much is B equal to? So answer, B is equal to root of H square plus BV square. Or you can relate it here, B is equal to H upon cos delta. So once we know the value of H, once we know the value of delta, we can find out BV, we can find out total V, both these things. So what should be known to us? Delta as well as H. That gives the complete information of B, and this is known as H horizontal component. So now there are three factors of Earth's magnetic field. One is declination, which gives us one information about the direction. Other is angle of dip, which gives the direction with respect to horizon. Third is H, which gives the intensity in horizontal direction. At this point, if I know all these three things, I have all the parameter of Earth's magnetic field. That is why you will see, like your log table and other tables, there are tables prepared for delta and H and declination at different locations of the Earth. All important towns and everywhere, these three informations are given. So we can find out the Earth's magnetic field at all the places. Then when you advance in this, you will find there are lines, there are diagrams with the lines on the Earth, which says which are the places of similar declination, which are the places of similar H, which are the places of similar angle of dip. Like that, we go on increasing our knowledge. But this is the basic or the fundamental information about all these three. So with this, we conclude information of Earth's magnetic field and the chapter of material magnetism and Earth as a magnet. Now, we are going to start a new chapter, that is electromagnetic induction, in the next lecture. Thank you.